डॉक्टर बी एम मोरे, असोसिएट प्रोफेसर इन इंजीनियरिंग फिजिक्स एट ब्रह्मदेव दादा माने इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ टेक्नोलॉजी सोलापुर. टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न अबाउट अल्ट्रासोनिक्स. एक्चुअली अल्ट्रासोनिक्स इज प्लेज ए मेजर रोल इन वेरियस फील्ड्स, स्पेशली एनडीटी, दैट इज नॉन डिस्ट्रक्टिव टेस्टिंग. एनडीटी नॉन destructive testing. So in non-destructive testing, that is NDT, which also plays a major role in medical field, then industrial field. So we will see in detail of ultrasonic. So ultrasonic waves are the sound waves. Ultrasonic waves are the sound waves having frequency greater than 20 kilohertz. Means ultrasonic waves are sound waves having frequency greater than 20 kilohertz. Means audible range of sound, it is between 20 hertz to 20 kilohertz. This is the audible range, means we can listen it, but the frequency which are greater than 20 kilohertz, we cannot listen it. So the sound waves, ultrasonic waves are sound waves. They are inaudible to us. We can't listen these sound waves. So these ultrasonic waves, or if we specially divide this into below this 20 hertz, it is infrasonic. Below 20 hertz, infrasonic. Between 20 hertz to 20 kilohertz, it is a sonic, that means audible range of sound. And above this 20 hertz to 20 kilohertz, above 20 kilohertz, it is ultrasonic. As these are inaudible to human beings, but there are certain animals like bat or dogs, they can listen these ultrasonic waves. Now the ultrasonic waves, as they have, or their velocity increases, or speed of the ultrasonic wave increases with increasing frequency, means their speed increases. As its frequency increases, means higher the frequency, higher will be the speed of ultrasonic waves. And as the frequency is higher, they produce less diffraction. The frequency higher, frequency of ultrasonic waves is higher. As the frequency is higher, they produce less diffraction or negligible diffraction. Now we will see how to produce these ultrasonic waves, means how these ultrasonic waves are produced. Basically there are many methods for the production of ultrasonic waves, but we will see two in details. First is magnetostriction method. And second one, which is piezoelectric method. So we will see one by one this. First, magnetostriction method. Actually this magnetostriction method is based on magnetostriction effect. And what is this magnetostriction effect? Magnetostriction to मुझे टू स्टडी दिस मैग्नेटोस्ट्रिक्शन इफेक्ट वी हैव टू कंसिडर ए रॉड ऑफ फेरोमैग्नेटिक मटेरियल एंड टू दिस फेरोमैग्नेटिक मटेरियल रॉड इफ वी अप्लाई मैग्नेटिक फील्ड पैरेलल टू इट्स लेंथ मैग्नेटिक फील्ड पैरेलल टू इट्स लेंथ देन देयर इज अ चेंज इन लेंथ म्हणजे आयदर लेंथ विल गेट इलॉन्गेटेड इलॉन्गेशन ऑफ लेंथ और देयर इज कॉन्ट्रॅक्शन ऑफ लेंथ इलॉन्गेशन ऑफ लेंथ और कॉन्ट्रॅक्शन ऑफ लेंथ दॅट मीन्स इफ वी अप्लाय अ मॅग्नेटिक फील्ड कॅन बी जनरेटेड थ्रू अप्लाइंग अ कॉइल टू थ्रीज सो इफ वी अप्लाय दिस मॅग्नेटिक फील्ड देन देयर इज अ चेंज इन इट्स डायमेन्शन मे चेंज it will get elongated or it will get contracted which is there is a contraction in length or elongation in length so that if we now apply a changing magnetic field to this then there will be continuously change in dimension of the length means apply the changing magnetic field you will get continuously changing length of this rod so that rod will get vibrated and if the frequency of vibration is greater than 20 kilohertz frequency of the vibration is greater than 20 kilohertz then automatically there will be production of ultrasonic waves means frequency of vibration of this rod gets greater than 20 kilohertz there will be automatically production of this ultrasonic waves but if we apply changing field then for every half cycle there will be change in length means every half cycle for positive half cycle there will be changing length for negative half cycle there will be changing length and because of this for one cycle of input there will be two times change in the length so the frequency will be double of the applied frequency means frequency of ultrasonic waves will be double the frequency of input magnetic field so that this frequency of magnetostriction method f is given by f is equal to 1 upon 2 l into square root of y divided by rho where this f is a frequency of this ultrasonic waves l is the length of the rod y is Young's modulus of elasticity and rho is the density of the material. So by using this formula we can calculate the frequency of this ferromagnetic material and this will be double the frequency of applied input frequency and this ferromagnetic method is used to produce a ultrasonic waves up to having frequency 300 kilohertz means up to having frequency 300 if you want to pay frequency below 300 kilohertz we can use this magnetostriction method and for the higher frequencies of ultrasonic waves we have to use piezoelectric method so we will see about piezoelectric method and this piezoelectric method is based on well known phenomena of piezoelectric effect so to study this piezoelectric method we have to first see piezoelectric effect and now what is this piezoelectric effect to observe a piezoelectric effect we have to consider a piece of a quartz crystal and to this piece of a quartz crystal if we apply a mechanical pressure to this quartz crystal opposite faces of this quartz crystal if we apply a mechanical pressure to this opposite faces of quartz crystal like this is the applied pressure p and this is in this direction applied pressure p then there will be a development of charges opposite to these two means other than these two faces which are exactly opposite means there will be a development of charges on these faces for one side there will be positive charges and exact opposite phase there will be a negative charges. Means piezoelectric effect says that if we apply a pressure to a crystal or quartz crystal, then on opposite faces, then there will be development of charges on the other than this the other opposite faces. One side there will be a positive charges and other on other side there will be negative charges. Now instead of applying this pressure, now we apply tension to this. If we apply tension to this opposite sides, tension T, then there will be changes in sign. Means instead of positive to this side there will be a negative charges, and instead of negative charges here will be positive charges developed if we apply tension. Means if we apply pressure, their charges will be positive negative, and if we change or reverse the, instead of pressure if we apply tension, then there will be a change in charges, there will be change in sign of the charges. This is piezoelectric method. But we have to use inverse of this piezoelectric method. Inverse of piezoelectric method. What is inverse of piezoelectric method? Means can reverse true. Upon piezoelectric, we have seen piezoelectric effect, wherein we are applying the pressure across or tension across the crystal, and we are getting charges developed across that. So can reverse true, or what is inverse? So inverse of piezoelectric effect is that what we have to do, we have to apply electric charges to the opposite faces of quartz crystal so that there will be change in dimension of the quartz crystal. So there will be change in that is the inverse of piezoelectric effect. Means we have to apply changing field, you will get changing dimension so that this crystal will get vibrated. And vibration of any material produces sound waves, and if its frequency is greater than 20 kilohertz, then you will get automatically ultrasonic waves. That means in this case what we have to do, we have to apply electric charges to the opposite faces of this crystal or quartz crystal so that you will get mechanical change in dimension or mechanical motion along the other opposite faces, so that this quartz crystal will get vibrated. Vibration of any material produces sound waves, and if its frequency is greater than 20 kilohertz, then we can produce a ultrasonic waves. That means we have to apply a changing voltage which has frequency greater than 20 kilohertz, then you will get the sound waves of frequency greater than 20 hertz. And this piezoelectric method, it is useful for production of a ultrasonic waves which have frequency greater than 300 kilohertz. Means if you want the higher frequency ultrasonic waves, you have to use this piezoelectric method. If you want to produce a ultrasonic waves of frequency greater less than 300 kilohertz, in that case you can use the magnetostriction method. So depending upon the applications of this, you can decide the which method is suitable for the production of ultrasonic waves. And this frequency in the piezoelectric method is given by 1 upon 2L into square root of, instead of Young's modulus, it is a modulus of elasticity E. So L, again it will be length of the crystal, quartz crystal. Then E is modulus of elasticity, elasticity, and again rho is the density of the material. And from this we can calculate the frequency of ultrasonic waves. Now, so these are the two methods which are used for the production of ultrasonic waves. One is a magnetostriction method, and second is piezoelectric method. Now we have to see properties of ultrasonic waves. Ultrasonic waves. properties of ultrasonic waves. So first property of ultrasonic wave is they are highly energetic. They are highly energetic. Highly energetic. Their frequency is higher, means ultrasonic waves. Second property is ultrasonic waves are the sound waves. Sound waves having frequency greater than 20 kilohertz. Means they are highly energetic sound waves, their frequency is greater than 20 kilohertz. As the frequency is higher, the speed of this ultrasonic wave is higher. So higher the speed because of higher the frequency. The speed is higher as frequency is higher. Frequency is higher. Then they have less diffraction. You are negligible diffraction. They have negligible diffraction. They produce negligible amount of diffraction. Highly energetic. Also, they produce cavitation effect. Also, they produce cavitation effect. Cavitation effect, which is useful for the cleaning purpose. And lastly, they have less divergence, so that they can travel for longer distance with minimum loss of energy. So these are the basic properties of ultrasonic material. That means they are highly energetic. Sound waves having frequency greater than 20 kilohertz, we are calling these as ultrasonic waves. Speed is high because of higher frequency. They have negligible diffraction. They produce cavitation effect, which is useful for the cleaning purpose. They have less divergence, and because of that they travel for longer distance with minimum loss of energy. So these are the some of the properties of the ultrasonic waves. Okay.